Daniel Ricciardo's exit from Formula One has left a honeybadger-shaped hole in the sport, and although not always the fastest driver on the track, he was undoubtedly one of the most loved and stole the show on more than one occasion. Much has been made of the Aussie's return to F1, with many fans wondering where his next move lies. Well, it looks like Daniel has laid the gauntlet down on Red Bull, and it could be Red Bull's current number two driver worrying about his position. Want to know the bombshell that Ricciardo dropped on Red Bull and Sergio Perez? And could we see the return of the honey badger? Stick around to the end to find out. Ricciardo's departure from McLaren added to one of the silliest of silly seasons of the F1 driver market. Sebastian Vettel had announced his retirement from F1, and a day later Fernando Alonso revealed he would be replacing the German quadruple world champion at Aston Martin. Having sacked Ricciardo, McLaren then announced that they were recruiting fellow Australian and Alpine junior driver Oscar Piastri. Ricciardo's exit from McLaren was shocking but not unexpected, with the Red Bull reserve driver lacking both form and pace in the tricky MCL 36, but as the saying goes, as one door closes, another door opens.
Dueling in the background as well, Albon had a run, off the road goes Oscar Piastri.
Now, with Daniel, that door was in the form of a return to his former employer, Red Bull, and a possibility to take a year away from the sport, rebuild his confidence, and find his spark to race at the very top again. So, given this, many viewed Ricciardo as the wolf in sheep's clothing for Sergio Perez. There have long been rumors that Red Bull would prefer to have Ricciardo next to Max than Perez, and it looks like Ricciardo agrees, in particular after his recent statements.
We see the move from Piastri on Hülkenberg, I love a bit of that.
Now, essentially, Ricciardo is taking a gap year from F1, and we'll be honest, if we could take a gap year from a sport and earn an estimated $24.3 million while doing it, then sign us up. While the majority of this will come from his breakup with McLaren, about $22 million of it, the remainder of this will come from his contract with Red Bull as a reserve driver and a Red Bull ambassador. Ricciardo's role for 2023 will include simulator work at the team's factory in the United Kingdom, as well as the opportunity to drive the car at various tyre tests.
Perez in the thick of it as well, in the midfield on those hard tyres, but the gainer there is Hamilton, got great traction.
He'll also be present at races throughout the season, as well as performing at such events as the Red Bull Formula Nürburgring event, which the Aussie driver is not exactly looking forward to. The shortened Nordschleife is over 20 kilometers in length and is fraught with danger due to its elevation changes and sweeping bends, with legendary driver Jackie Stewart once labeling the track as the Green Hell. I say I'm kinda scared. We're just going to go at our own pace, we're not trying to set any records. The Nordschleife, it's basically the craziest circuit in the world. It's like 13 or 14 miles long or something. Dangerous and scary, Ricciardo told Sky Sports the grandstand. As much as Ricciardo will probably enjoy his drive at the Green Hell, we all know it's not where he wants to be. He wants to be back on the F1 track, racing in the illustrious Monaco or racing around the iconic Silverstone. Well, his return may not be that far away, with Horner saying the Aussie is fit and ready to go if needed. He's in good shape, he's kept himself fit and well, he's training hard, and he's ready to go if he's given a chance. I'd say he's about 10 minutes away from being ready. Having had time off over Christmas to reset, he's come back and hit the ground running. He likes the feel of the car in the virtual world, which would seem to correlate well with what we see in the actual world. We're certainly seeing him getting back to being far more reminiscent of the Daniel we knew, said Horner. Well, brilliant news for Daniel then, right? Well, not exactly. Although the Aussie driver may be fit and raring to go, will he really be getting the opportunities at Red Bull? Sergio Perez's recent dip in form has many people thinking that the time may just be suitable for a sneaky driver change, the Milton Keynes-based team, and the current reserve driver feels like he is fit and ready to go. The signs are pointing towards getting back on the grid. I want to go back with a top team, and a team where I have the confidence back and my mojo, he added. To go back and to maybe put myself in a seat that's fighting for at best top 10, I don't think it's going to bring the best out of me, Ricciardo said. The fighting talk from Daniel Ricciardo is excellent and pretty much what any team principal will want to hear, and even though Sergio Perez is contracted until 2024. Having someone in the paddock putting him under pressure should be getting the best out of him. If you said this three races ago, we should have agreed with you, but after Sergio's recent slump in form, this doesn't appear to be the case. The most worrying thing about this all is that his teammate is currently in cruise control and waltzing to victory. Surely this is not where Sergio wants to be. To add further pressure to the Mexican, Daniel has already said how it would be his dream to finish at Red Bull. This for me would be like a fairy tale, Ricciardo told ESPN when he asked about getting back in a Red Bull seat in the future. Honestly, the fairy tale ending would be to finish my career here, and if I could have it all my own way, but we'll see. I'll probably have to work my way up a little, but it's really nice to be back here. Of course, Daniel would love to get back at the current Red Bull. I mean, who wouldn't? The car is a rocket. Lewis and Alonso are looking at the Red Bull with envy. What really intrigues us is the timing of the conversation. Before the Australian Grand Prix, the tone from Daniel was very different. Pretty much, he just said he wants to race for a top team, nothing about racing for Red Bull. Now, all of a sudden, when Sergio is going through a slump in form, he says he wants to be finishing his career at Red Bull. Very strange indeed, and exactly what you should be doing in order to put the pressure on Horner to show that you are not only willing to put in the time, but you're also wishing to take the heat if needed.
Better traction off the corner! Oh, and into the wall! Into the wall goes Magnussen, who has to
We're not really sure what to think about it, but are we the only ones to think that Daniel's timing is really odd, or are we reading too much into it? Now, interestingly enough, if you noticed, Daniel also changed his tone about the caliber of the team he's looking to join. As previously, he was only looking to join a top team, now in his recent statement, he looks to be joining anyone and work his way back up. Again, a very interestingly timed statement after the Canadian Grand Prix, AlphaTauri is now last in the Constructors' Championship, adding fuel to the fire. It really doesn't look good when one of your teams is in the top of the pile while the other is at the bottom, and with pressure already mounting on Nyck de Vries and Yuki Tsunoda. Reports last month which suggested that Ricciardo was set to replace an underperforming Nyck de Vries so far have proved to be wide of the mark. AlphaTauri's team boss Franz Tost is a firm believer that it takes 3 years for a driver new to Formula 1 to find their feet. Speaking specifically about his newly recruited Formula E champion driver in Monaco, Tost said, "And Nick, as I always say, if a rookie is coming to Formula 1, he needs a minimum of 3 years to understand what's going on here." However, with Tost retiring at the end of the year and Laurent Mekies due to replace him, the young Dutchman may not get the time he requires to come up to speed, and that small gap could be exploited by Daniel Ricciardo. So, if Nick is to get his time, then the most likely option would be the inconsistently consistent Yuki Tsunoda, who has the unwanted record of finishing 11th more times than anyone else. He's scored just 2 points in 8 races this season, which sees the Faenza-based team rooted firmly at the bottom of the constructors' table, even behind the Williams team. Now, for a more wild theory for all of those tinfoil hat wearers out there, a long shot is that Alex Albon may replace Sergio Perez and not Daniel Ricciardo. The rumor has been fueled by how Horner addressed the Formula Red Bull's race during the Canadian Grand Prix, stating how he watched as much of Albon's race as he did his own driver's, which we will agree is rather peculiar. Ted Kravitz, however, has his doubts. Are they really going to get Albon back? Ricciardo is the obvious one if you're not ready to promote Liam Lawson. Who's next in the Red Bull staircase of talent? And they don't think that Yuki Tsunoda and Nyck de Vries are quite right for Red Bull Racing, which Helmut Marko and Christian Horner have pretty much already made clear. Then give Ricciardo a go, said Kravitz. We probably agree with Ted, but we have seen